Thank you, Madam Chair. A year and a half ago, this Parliament, with a two-thirds majority, approved a pragmatic reform of the Dublin Regulation. After very difficult work, I must say, we managed to join five groups in a text that actually points out the need for a truly European compromise. We voted for a proposal that would ensure solidarity between member states, where every member state would play a positive part in correcting the failures of the current system. We improved the Commission proposal by ensuring immediate registration and security screenings of applicants, reasonable balance, easing the burden on frontline member states, and a fair sharing of responsibilities of all. Our text would incentivize applicants to work with the authorities instead of driving them to abscond and make use of smugglers. What I want to see is an orderly asylum system in Europe where those in need of protection that reach our shores would receive exactly that. And those that don't comply with the criteria would be sent back. We did our homework in this House. What did Member States do? They have dug themselves deeper into the trenches. All of them seem to worry mostly about themselves, and no one is ready to find a compromise. Now, I quote Commissioner Avramopoulos, "Open your eyes. We are all-time low on migration at this moment, and still there are few that manage to reach our shores, and those we need to take full responsibility of, and we should do it jointly together." The result that we see of Member States now is that people rescued at sea have to wait for weeks in full despair and desperation as Member States haggle over their future. With every failure of Member States, the bar seems to be set lower and lower. Believe me, Madam Chair, Judgment Day will come, and generations to come will ask all of us, why did you allow this to happen? Why? No one can give a full response to that, a full answer. But we know that we managed to put systems together on everything except from human beings. The day has come for us to deliver.